In this video, I'm going to talk about affinity audience targeting and how it can work with your YouTube ads. Welcome to my channel. My name is Kyle Sulerud. I'm the founder of a YouTube ad targeting software called VidHoarder. And today, let's talk about affinity audience targeting. I made another video about in-market audiences. In-market audiences are based on people's recent search and browsing behavior. Affinity audiences are based on people's long-term behavior. So affinity audiences are basically people's interests and habits. And to quote Google, with affinity audiences, you can reach people based on a holistic picture of their lifestyles, passions, and habits. Affinity audiences have demonstrated a qualified passion in a given topic. Now, I think they're using the word passion kind of loosely here. You can definitely end up in affinity lists for things that you are not passionate about. Now, there is a relatively short list of affinity audiences that Google has created for us to be able to target. And they are mostly not very specific. It's things like do-it-yourselfers, cat lovers, bargain hunters, and racquetball enthusiasts. Now, sure, if I was selling a product related to racquetball, that racquetball enthusiast audience might be a good fit, but for most of the campaigns that I'm running for clients, I'm actually not using affinity audience targeting, and the reason is there just isn't a good fit for what my clients are selling. Maybe there will be a list that is an okay match, but the size and the reach of those lists is usually just too broad, and it would end up being a waste of money because we'd be targeting too many of the wrong people. Let's look at an example. When you're in the Google Ads platform, you can hover over the name of an affinity list to get some more information about it. So if I'm looking at this social media enthusiasts list, Google's telling me that these are people who spend significant time engaging with social media, including social networks, microblogging platforms, and other online communities. And we can assume this would be a huge list because of how many people spend so much time on social media. And we can confirm that based on the estimated impressions Google is giving us. 10 billion to 1 trillion estimated impressions per week. That tells us there are a lot of people in this audience. Below that, we can also see top related audiences. And this is basically Google telling us where there is a lot of overlap. So a lot of people who are in the social media enthusiast audience are also in the nightlife enthusiast audience and the shutterbugs audience. And then you see the new houses for sale audience, which doesn't necessarily make a ton of sense, until you remember that these are huge, huge groups of people. So there's going to be a lot of overlap when comparing any two really large groups of people. The nightlife enthusiast and shutterbugs audiences, those are other affinity audiences, but the new houses for sale audience, that is an in-market audience. So you'll also get recommended audiences of different types, in-market or affinity. And at the bottom of this pop-up box, you see top YouTube categories. And these are actually topics. You could go target these topics if you want, but Google is basically telling us that people who are in this audience are watching a lot of the videos that are in these topics. You'll want to always check out the affinity audience lists to see if there is a good match for what you are advertising, but don't expect great results from these lists, unless maybe you are selling a product that has a very broad mass appeal. Affinity audience lists are usually just not very specific, and they have a lot of people on them. To see a complete list of the affinity audiences Google has available for us to target, click the link in the description. My team put together a guide that's going to help you find targeting that you can use in your YouTube ads. It's completely free, there's nothing to sign up for, and I think you'll find it very useful. Thanks for watching this video. If you learned something, be sure to hit the like button. And if you want to see more videos from me about YouTube ads, be sure to subscribe. My name is Kyle Sulerud, and I will see you in the next video.